For Israel, Syria is really a four-letter word, Iran. That was Prime Minister Netanyahu's message to new Navy officers last week and to President Obama. Speaking of Syria's chemical weapons, he said, quote, "The world must make sure that whoever uses weapons of mass destruction pays a price for it." The message that is received in Syria, he said, will be received loudly in Iran. Here, every move that President Obama makes on Syria is seen through the prism, can Israel trust Obama to stop Iran's nuclear weapons program? It's especially relevant this weekend, the 40th anniversary of the 1973 Yom Kippur War, when Syria and Egypt launched a surprise attack against Israel. The American president back then ordered a weapons airlift that helped save the Jewish state. Based on President Obama's handling of the Syrian crisis, how confident are Israeli officials now that he will stop Iran from making a nuclear weapon? Shimon Schiffer is an Israeli political reporter.
Policymakers, they are not going to attack in public President Obama, but...
What do they say in private?
In private, they are saying that the lesson from the way that he dealt with the Syrian issue, it's a very difficult one for Israel. A lot of policymakers, ministers, they will tell you in private that after all, Israel will have to deal unilaterally with the to stop the nuclear effort of Iran to become a country with a nuclear power.
In recent weeks, Israeli citizens prepared for a possible American attack on Syria that they feared would provoke a Syrian attack on their country. Home front stations gave out thousands of gas masks across the country, and Israel rushed its Iron Dome anti-rocket defense systems into place. There's Jerusalem in the distance. It was protected by Israel's Iron Dome battery right here. But the same day that President Obama went on national TV and accepted the Russian initiative for a diplomatic solution to Syria, the Israelis removed the Iron Dome from this position. Nothing says more clearly the drop in tension. At this Tel Aviv storehouse, gas mask handouts have slowed to a trickle. For now, at least, diplomacy has diffused the Syrian crisis. And there are reports that a new diplomatic initiative could be underway with Iran to resolve the nuclear issue peacefully. Also, Iran just announced it had cut its stockpile of 20% enriched uranium by half.
There has to be a negotiation.
Itamar Rabinovich is the former Israeli ambassador to the United States.
There has to be a strategy allowing Iran to climb off the tree. And it could work, and there could be a diplomatic solution. But without a credible threat of military action, the Iranians will not collaborate in a diplomatic solution.
But Netanyahu stressed earlier this week, Israel must know how to defend itself.
In a way, he's exerting pressure on Obama, indicating that if the United States doesn't do what the United States undertook to do, then Israel might have to do it itself. That pressure needs to be there. There has to be an American pressure on Iran, and there has to be an Israeli pressure on America.